So we've just been in the room for about an hour, having a little power nap. We were going to go back to Animal Kingdom, but we've actually decided we're going to go to Magic Kingdom, and we've got a fast pass for the Jungle Cruise, so we'll see you when we get there.
Our method of searching for fast passes on the day, as soon as you use one, has worked out very well. We've just got a last minute Seven Dwarfs Mine Train fast pass, which is literally 30 minutes from now, and we're about to go on the Jungle Cruise. So by the time we've ridden it, walked over, David's good at this. This is his like skill for the holidays.
I enjoy doing it. It gives me a rush.
The adrenaline.
It does. You get such a rush.
Cruise where we are famous around the world for being world famous. Yeah. My name is Paige, and I'm going to be your skipper for the next three lovely weeks. Yeah. I'm also going to be your dance instructor, your lion tamer, and if you guys forget to laugh at my jokes, I'm also going to be your swimming instructor. You know, whatever, it's fine. Because now we're on to the best part of the tour. It's why you're not in this boat. It's to see the one, the only, the eighth wonder of the world. Pictures as you'd like. They are all decent today. They're wearing their trunks. Yeah. Now, fun fact about elephants. Did you guys know that elephants have the best memory in the world? Yeah, I really wish I had a memory like that. I feel like it'd be really helpful for my job, right?
I'm just about to try some cheeseburger spring rolls. There you go.
Cheeseburger.
Got a hint of McDonald's Quarter Pounder burger.
That's what everyone says, it tastes like McDonald's burgers.
Yeah.
Good then?
Yep.
Do you prefer that to the Cuban that we tried last year?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got the pepperoni pizza ones, which come with like a sauce.
I'm going to try this without the sauce first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
Out of 10. Oh, it looks good.
It is.
Right. Should we divulge in these then?
7 out of 10, I reckon. 7.5.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Right. We're going to divulge these, and then we've got seven dwarfs fast pass. So yeah.
Did you like that?
Yeah.
Oh my lord.
It has its days, doesn't it? Sometimes, I think literally, this is one ride where it really matters where you sit.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you're like, meh. But now, like, it's reasonably, what, in the middle?
So we are now on our way over to Adventures of the Little Mermaid for another fast pass. And then as soon as we get in the queue for that, we're going to see what we can get next.
That's the way to do it.
Yep, we've already been here what, like just over an hour?
Jungle Cruise, straight to Seven Dwarfs, straight onto Ariel.
Yeah.
And
we've been here just over an hour and we're going to have been on three rides. So that's pretty good going.
So we're just getting onto the Little Mermaid, and David,
just as we're getting into the shell, this looks like,
just as we're getting into the shell,
David has managed to get us a Space Mountain Fastpass for 5 minutes. So what happened?
So by the time we got into the shell, obviously when we last said we got the fast pass, by the time we got off, when we got off, I got a ding saying, we've done something to your fast pass.
Space is down.
We got multiple experiences, it's down, so we're heading over to Thunder.
Yeah, we thought if we can't ride one mountain, we'll go do the other, so.
Is our fourth or fifth ride here at Magic Kingdom. Skip a Jungle Cruise, Seven Dwarfs, Little Mermaid, Thunder. Fifth ride in what? 2 and a bit hours? Just over 2 hours?
Yeah, something like that.
Check us out, hey?
We got a purple one!
So we are just coming up to Dumbo, which will be our sixth fast pass of the evening. And then once we get in here, we're going to try and get something else. But I love Dumbo. Dumbo is one of my absolute favourites.
Mm-hmm.
Walking onto the Barnstormer, which gives us quite a good view of the Tron stuff that's going on behind here. Oh wow, David.
That's Space Mountain, that's not.
No, the track.
Oh whoa, yeah.
That's pretty boss.
Wow.
That's going to be awesome.
So that's the main building.
Whoa, it's the most ever cinema.
So this here is the main building and you can see where the track comes out. And then this bit here all loops round. And if it's like Shanghai, it's going to have that big dome structure over the top of this part. But it's going to be huge.
That's going to be amazing. That's come on like leaps and bounds.
Well, when we were here in May, it was just the poles.
Well, like watching the videos as well.
David's first goal of us.
Never done this before.
Gosh. Make sure don't poop the pants.
Oh, that is beautiful, isn't it?
Going to David's favourite! Hi everyone! So we had the best afternoon slash evening in Magic Kingdom. We kind of did a redo of our May trip when we had an unplanned trip to Magic Kingdom and ended up riding a ton of rides using unplanned fast passes. So tonight I think we rode a total, or did a total of 9 attractions. 8 out of 9 of them were fast passes, and they were Jungle Cruise, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, Thunder Mountain, Little Mermaid, Winnie the Pooh, Dumbo, Barnstormer, Haunted Mansion, and then we queued and met Goofy and Donald at Pete's Silly Sideshow. So that was really, really good. We had a really successful evening. Our biggest tip to people is as soon as you get into one fast pass queue and you've checked in and you've scanned your band and that green light has flashed, get on the app and start refreshing the whole time and you're in the queue, and you can pretty much get fast passes one after the other for a lot of rides. So considering we were in the park for 3.5-4 hours tops, it was a pretty successful day. We actually got more done in the 4 hours we were there today with nothing planned in advance than we did on our first day of the holiday at Magic Kingdom, where we had 3 fast passes planned. So if you're smart, you can get lots and lots done, which is fab. We haven't really had anything to eat for dinner tonight, so we're just gonna walk over to the Mara and get something to share, fill up our refillable mugs, and then we're gonna have an early night because we're gonna get up early tomorrow to try for Rise of the Resistance. So we will film that experience, let you know how it goes, keep you up to date throughout the day with everything, and we'll let you know whether we actually think it's worthwhile getting up super early to do it. Overall, it's been such a good day. We were saying earlier we had just the best morning. I cannot recommend enough getting a 8 a.m. reservation for Animal Kingdom at Tusker House for breakfast, so you get in an hour before park opening.
We weren't rushed at Tusker House at all. We had everything we wanted. We met all the characters, had great experiences. And then we were out, like we said, by 8:40, quarter to nine. And we were first in line for the safari and had a really great experience. So literally can't recommend doing that enough. It was like such a good morning, wasn't it?
See.
And then, yeah, we came back to the room. I had a power nap. Oops. And
I was sitting there glaring at her for 2 hours nearly.
Yeah, pretty much. And then, yeah, we went Magic Kingdom. And like I said, we had a really good evening again. Anyway.
But it's great. Right.
We'll leave you. We might speak to you after we've had the food, but probably not. So maybe in the morning.
Because we need an early one because Ashleigh's getting up early.
We're both getting up early. It'll be hopefully it'll be worth it. Right. We'll see
you're going to know if it's not.
We'll see to you later. Bye.
How I've tried, written down the words to say. It is time, I've been waiting 5 days to explain how you make me feel inside. Baby, got it all figured out, wanna do